Apollo 1. On January 27, 1967, the first American space tragedy occurred not in the vacuum of space, but on the ground. During a routine plugs-out launch rehearsal, a fire erupted inside the Apollo 1 command module, killing the three-man crew, veteran astronaut Gus Grissom, Ed White, the first American to walk in space, and rookie Roger Chaffee. Investigators concluded the ignition was most likely an electrical arc/short, and the high-pressure pure oxygen cabin, plus combustible materials, made the fire spread with extreme speed. The disaster was made inescapable by a fatal design flaw, an inward opening hatch that the crew could not open against the intense internal pressure. The tragedy forced a complete redesign of the Apollo capsule, leading to a safer, outward opening hatch and the removal of flammable materials. It was a brutal and costly lesson, but the safety improvements it mandated were absolutely critical to the eventual success of the moon landings. Soyuz 1. Cosmonaut Vladimir Komarov became the first human to die during a spaceflight mission on April 24, 1967. Later stories that he knew the mission was doomed are disputed and often exaggerated. Soyuz 1 flew under intense schedule and political pressure, and serious technical problems were raised before launch, including a widely cited list of over 200 design issues. Komarov was aware the spacecraft had serious problems, but the claim that he flew to save Yuri Gagarin is not well supported and is commonly treated as legend. From the moment it reached orbit, the mission was a cascade of catastrophic failures. A solar panel failed to deploy, starving the craft of power, and its guidance systems failed. Komarov brought the spacecraft through re-entry, but the primary parachute system failed, and the reserve parachute became ineffective after it tangled with the still-attached drogue. The capsule hit the ground at roughly 144 kilometers per hour, about 90 miles per hour, killing him on impact. The accident halted crewed Soyuz flights until Soyuz 3 in October 1968 and drove major design and quality control changes, laying groundwork for the long-running Soyuz system that followed. Soyuz 11. The three cosmonauts of Soyuz 11, Georgi Dobrovolsky, Vladislav Volkov, and Viktor Patsayev, are the only human beings to have ever died in space itself. Their mission was, until its final moments, a spectacular triumph. In June 1971, they had successfully docked with and become the first crew to inhabit the world's first space station, Salyut 1, setting a new space endurance record. But on June 30th, during separation events on the return to Earth, a pressure equalization valve was jolted open, triggering rapid depressurization. The capsule depressurized so fast that the crew became incapacitated within tens of seconds and died in under a minute. Because the capsule was a cramped three-man configuration, the crew was not wearing pressure suits. They died of asphyxiation before they ever hit the atmosphere. After Soyuz 11, Soyuz crews wore pressure suits for launch and re-entry landing, and modern programs generally emphasize suits for the most critical phases, especially launch and entry, though practices vary by vehicle. Space Shuttle Challenger. On January 28, 1986, the Space Shuttle Challenger broke apart just 73 seconds after liftoff, an event that became a shared national trauma. All seven astronauts were killed: Commander Dick Scobee, Pilot Michael Smith, Mission Specialists Ronald McNair, Ellison Onizuka, and Judith Resnick, Payload Specialist Gregory Jarvis, and Krista McAuliffe, the first teacher in space whose presence brought millions of schoolchildren to watch the launch live. The disaster was caused by failure of the primary and secondary O-ring seals in the aft field joint of the right solid rocket booster. The record low temperatures reduced the O-ring's ability to seal. Engineers had warned that launching in such conditions was unsafe, but their concerns were overruled. The Rogers Commission investigation exposed deep flaws in NASA's management and safety culture, grounding the shuttle fleet for nearly 3 years and forever changing the way the agency assesses risk. Space Shuttle Columbia. On February 1, 2003, the Space Shuttle Columbia disintegrated upon re-entry into Earth's atmosphere at the end of a successful 16-day science mission, killing all 7 astronauts on board, Rick Husband, William McCool, Michael Anderson, David Brown, Kalpana Chawla, Laurel Clark, and Elin Ramone. The cause of the disaster was damage that had occurred during launch, when a piece of insulating foam from the external tank broke off and struck the orbiter's left wing. The impact created a breach in the thermal protection system on the leading edge of the left wing, allowing superheated entry gases to penetrate and destroy the wing structure. While some engineers had suspected the damage, NASA's management failed to act on their concerns. After Columbia, the shuttle fleet was grounded, return to flight changes were implemented, and in early 2004, the U.S. plan became complete ISS assembly and then retire the shuttle program, ultimately in 2011. Thanks for watching. With Artemis and commercial crews flying again, what risk level do you think is acceptable for pushing deeper into space? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Please also remember to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video.